In this video, we build a chatting and talking fully local RAG with Llama 3, Ollama, LangChain ChromaDB, and Elevenlabs. We use all of these elements to build a pipeline step by step, and I'll show you how. And we can chat with it, but we also can talk to it. Hi everyone, I'm Mayim. I have 20 plus years experience in AI, applying it to 12 different industries for real world projects. And nowadays I train hundreds of people to do the same. I went through a lot of RAG pipelines and I noticed low performance or low speed. I found an optimized solution to all of the steps. I spent a lot of time, but now the summary is really compact and really easy for you guys to follow. In the first step, I'm gonna suggest just one small swap that it will improve your quality by a lot. Let's dive in. So the first step is to parse our PDF. We are using LangChain Community PyPDF Loader, and the rest is basically a for loop which will find the path loaded, will put it in pages, which is loader.load. Then I've got Nvidia and Tesla PDF files. I will separate them. I will make actually pages. But there is a very big problem with this approach. Let me show you. If we check out all of the PDFs of Nvidia, you can see that there are tables, and we wanted actually to understand this whole table. Also more complex tables, but things like a graph, for example, in a Tesla file, or a little bit different formatted tables. We could also have invoices which are scanned, and PyPDF loader will not understand that. A lot of people in the community use unstructured. Unstructured uses OCR, and that's a little bit better. But there is another solution. For loading multiple PDFs which are complex, we can use PDF Plumber Loader, which is also from the LangChain community. So with this very small swap, you can improve the quality. In this step, I want you to focus on the chunk size. If your chunk size is too small, later on if you use our retriever, then it will be less context for retriever to understand. And if it's too big, then it's too much of information. So it's important to find an optimal chunk size for your problem. The second step is to split our text. So we can just use the LangChain text splitter, recursive character text splitter. So you can give a chunk size and a chunk overlap, because if you are chunking and there are some words that are kind of cut in half, we want a little bit of overlap. The only thing that we want to do is for each of the pages doing the split and adding it to our chunks. And the chunks will look like this. As you can see, it has some backslash n, etc. If you have a lot of tables, you will see a lot of backslash t. Imagine you want to add some metadata. This is a step to do that. You will do just some metadata like title, author, or date. This is when you have a lot of documents and you want to do a proper metadata. It's pretty straightforward. After splitting the text, now we can go ahead and do embedding. In this step, I want you to pay attention to the type of embedding I'm using. I'm going to use another swap, same as PDF parser, that's going to add a lot of quality to your RAG pipeline. Let's dive in. If you want to go for speed, it's as easy as getting the fast embed embedding. And it is from the LangChain community. It's really simple, just one line of code, and then you're done with it. But the quality of embedding will drastically affect the quality of your end results when you're chatting with your RAG and asking all of these complex questions. So let me show you an alternative which delivers way more quality. And this is where we also enter working with Ollama. If you're wondering why we need Ollama, Ollama is this framework which puts all of the LLMs, and you can use it locally. It has a quantization. It just decreases the complexity of LLM for speed and performance. It's very simple. You go ahead and press download on ollama.com. Then you will do pip install Ollama. I wanted to use Google Colab because of the GPUs available there. You need two extra lines of codes, as you can see here. You have the link to the code, so just follow the instruction. The embedding that I recommend is this one, Nomic. It's a very high performing open embedding, and I saw the results was way better with this embedding in comparison to Hugging Face embedding or FAISS embedding. So what I do in the code, I will go ahead and do Ollama pull Nomic embed tech, and it starts to pull it. It takes a few minutes. Do Ollama list. You can see that it has been downloaded. Now I can go ahead and do the embedding. As you can see, you just can do the embedding, ollama.embedding, and then give the model name, and the prompt is basically the chunk that you have, and that chunk is the text chunk, and then I can just append all of the embeddings. It's actually a vector of numbers. I've talked about this one also in my video about prefix tuning and prompt tuning. In this case, we need the embedding because we want to store it in our vector database in the next step. In this step, I'm going to show you how to optimize vector databases. I notice it's not about using a fancy database, but it's about persisting it. After embedding, the next step is to just go ahead and put those embeddings in a vector database. We're going to focus on ChromaDB. But I'm going to tell you also about Qdrant and FAISS. So Chroma is also in the vector databases from LangChain community. If you have metadata, you need to just take the chunks and just have the documents. Then you will have Chroma from documents. Then you will have the documents, for example, Nvidia's. Here you can either do the pass embeddings you have already done, or even put the embedding here. You can also say show progress, yes or no. Then you will have collection name. That's a kind of table name in a vector database. I immediately want to show you an improvement that will just speed up storing in ChromaDB, and that's using persist. So what you do is just adding a persist directory. We'll do the path here, and then you will say Nvidia store.persist. Just with these two small changes, you will add up a lot of speed and efficiency. To be complete, let's also take a look at the FAISS and Qdrant. Qdrant is very good when you go to production. So the code for FAISS is super similar to the one from ChromaDB. As you can see, vector databases from the LangChain, and then FAISS from documents. You give the document and the embedding, and then you're done with it. Qdrant looks a little bit more complicated, but it gives also more flexibility. So what you can do is ask for Qdrant client, then create collection, and you call the collection name, which is the table name, and then you give some configuration. And here you can say what kind of distance, so similarity function you want to use, and then you give also the size of embedding. I noticed that it's very sensitive to nonce and empties. You have to do some data pre-processing and cleaning beforehand. Next step is a multi-query retriever. This is the place where we start to chat with Llama, our local LLM using Ollama. So let's dive in. Because we want to talk with Llama 3, we need to pull it via Ollama. It will take a few minutes to install. And if I ask Ollama list, then I can see that Llama, the latest, is already there. By the way, you can do exactly the same with Mistral and Llama 3, 8B, any kind of model that you want actually to pick from Ollama. Now that we got our Llama ready, so we know there is a local model, we can just go ahead and use chat Ollama, give the model. Another thing is that we need actually a prompt. This is where we say, you're an AI language model. Your task is to generate 5 different versions of the given user question to retrieve relevant documents from a vector database. So we explicitly say that we want him to do that, actually search in a vector database. Remember that you can even say things like make a JSON file output from it. So you can just give a lot of instruction actually in this piece. And at the end, you just have the question appended to it. And the multi-query retriever, so our retriever, we say from LLM, we want actually that vector database we built already as a retriever. We've got our chat or Llama with the local model as chatting, and the prompt is the query prompt. Now we want a RAG prompt, which is like answer the questions only based on the following context, which the context is basically our retriever, and the question will come. Then we do chat prompt template from template, and then we will use this template. So these are actually the two main steps. Then we use LangChain to build our chains. So we've got the retriever and the question. Then we've got the prompt, which is going to be answering a question, our LLM and our str output parser. Just let me show the libraries, and all of them are from LangChain. Especially LangChain community has a lot. Now that we have our retriever and our model, we can go ahead and use this complete optimized pipeline as a stock advisor and chat with our fully local RAG. In a bit, I will show you how to use audio, but let's first take a look at the chat. One of the things that I immediately noticed is when you have a bad embedding, you will just lose the context. If you have the chunks are not good enough, you will just lose information. And so all of the steps were very important to get any good results. When I say what are the main revenue drivers for Nvidia, if I go to the PDF, you can see that the answers are just provided based on this first column. And we want them to just answer it based on the whole year and understanding the whole financial situation. And when I optimized it, the answers are more based on the whole document. Then I ask this, can you give me some financial advice on Nvidia? Should people consider buying the share, the stock? And it would give me this information of the revenue growth, gross margin, and then operating expenses, cash flow, share and dividend. I says, consider these factors, some points to ponder for a potential investor, and then in conclusion, while no investment is risky, it's an attractive option. When I didn't give all of the optimization, it gave me some general answers like you have to decide yourself. Let's go and do some audio. I was extremely curious about Elevenlabs because it's just a lot of noise around it. Apparently it's really good API. I did two things, English and multi-language. Let me explain to you. The libraries that you need is from Elevenlabs, you need Elevenlabs Play and Stream. Then you need an API key. Just go to elevenlabs.io, then log in with your Google account. Then you can go to app. Then on your profile, you can see API key. I already have one. So you can apply here, just create a key. And you can see I have some free credit, and I've used just 3% of that, so it doesn't go very fast. So you can use the free credits. You come back, you put your API key here, then use audio stream, and here you say client.generate. Then you give the text that you want to change to audio. Then you give your model, which is 11lab Turbo version 2. And then you say, I want a stream to be true. And I saved it to my disk because I was working in Google Colab and it's just a little bit complicated. And let me run that MP3 for you.
Can you some financial advice on Nvidia stock to the future? Should people consider buying it?
So as you can see, very good English. Then I try to do something in other language, in Dutch, in my language. And then I tried different models. None of them was so great, except this one. So it was 11 multi-language or multilingual version 2. So if we run that one, you can hear.
Vind je Nvidia financieel een sterke bedrijf en denk je of zijn aandeel gaat stijgen?
I'm not sure if you guys understand it, but before that it was just butchering the whole language, but now it was coming with the good language. I think there are like 25 languages, so not all of the languages are there, but I saw even Japanese, so that's very cool. Let's go to the next tip. So we have seen a lot from Ollama, LangChain, Elevenlabs even. But there is one another framework which is so crucial for LLMs, and that's Hugging Face. You can just make a lot of things with Hugging Face. You can do sentiment analysis, text summarization, translation, just in a few lines of code. And I have this video for you so you can watch how it is. I'll see you there.